Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin and welcome to the Naio Nails channel. In this video, we are going to do something that I love. If you know me well, you know that I love unicorns. So today, I'm going to show you how to create a unicorn silhouette with crystals. So excited. Can we get on my nail? I've done this before on Faye. So Faye came in for a brand new full set. We didn't film it. However, I've got a lovely little picture to show you. And basically we were like, oh, let's put some crystals on. And we just had this idea of doing a unicorn silhouette just in crystals. So, and it looked really nice. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna do it a little bit different. Basically using different crystals, that's all. Because you can use any crystals to do this. You can really have fun. So let's have some fun. I've got my tip colors that I'm going to use for the backgrounds. I'm going to use these gorgeous colors because I think they correspond really nicely. So we've got strawberry cream, which is a beautiful baby pink, and we've got velvet ribbon. It's a nice lilac. I think these colors are perfect for a unicorn. And then we have, from the Shimmer collection, we have Flamingo Fizz. That's got loads of shimmery particles in. And then, from the Platinum collection, we have Velvet Rose. A lot of velvet's going on, isn't there, in this collection here? And that's a lavender kind of colour with a lot of sparkle. So what I'm going to do first of all is use my flat colours. When I say flat colours, these don't have any shimmer in them or sparkle. They are flat colours. Some people like to call them a cream colour because they have no shimmer. And I'm going to apply it at an angle. So I'm working on a tip today. If you were going to do this on a natural nail, you would apply the Urban Graffiti base coat. But if you were using it on acrylic, you can go straight onto the acrylic. I'm going to use my ombre brush and just tap and pull the product out so it's nice and thin. So this ombre brush that I've got, I have actually made a video showing you how to make your very own ombre brush. Pretty cool. I'm sure it'll be linked somewhere. Adam will go. I'm going to pop that in the lamp now, cure that layer, and then we'll move on to the other colour. So with strawberry cream, we're going to put that on towards this corner. I want to do like a diagonal blend. So again, go in with my ombre brush and pat and stretch the polish. I'm going to use the pink first and then I'll blend over the lilac. So we're going to go again. So we've got a nice colour. It's a true colour, I'd like to say. So we're going to do the same effect. Got to cure that. So we're going to meet that blend that we've done before. Then I'm going to use my brush again and blend this out. What I'm going to do now is get the corresponding shimmers. So this is the platinum one, so that's rose velvet. I'm just going to use my brush and blend up a little bit, just to add a little bit of sparkle. And then on the other side, I'm going to use the pink I'm going to do the same kind of thing. I'm going to top coat with the Urban Graffiti top coat. This has no sticky layer. And then I'm going to pop that into the lamp and give that a cure. Now what I'm going to do with this is I'm going to mat it off by buffing it. Because what I'm going to do is draw out the design with a pencil. Now this is just, I mean, I can do this by eye, but not everybody can. And this is a really good way to lay out a design that you're going to do, especially when you're doing loads of crystals. I'm going to wipe over with some gel residue wipe over solution. It's not called that. It's called gel residue wipe off solution. Such a mouthful. So that's going to take off any debris, any dust. And I'm going to take my pencil, and you could look at a unicorn. I mean, we've got a unicorn right here, haven't we? Just so happened to have a unicorn that Sue bought me. It's lovely. So yeah, you can look at one and think, oh yeah, if you just look at like the side profile of it. So it's this side view that we're going to do. So you want to get like this. Is this called a snout?
Mm, I think so,
just
yeah.
The nostrils.
Shrek.
Poke his nose. So yeah, that's what we're going to sketch out. So I'm going to start, where the neck sort of joins the face. And the neck will be there. So this is the jawline. Good thing with a pencil is you can just get off any bits that you think, oh no, that's not right. You can just take that off. So you've got that basic shape for your unicorn. I'm going to top coat this, which it might think that's a bit weird, but no, we can want everything shiny before we put the stones on. And then I'm going to use the Acrygel, which is an awesome product. Now this is, it's clear, dear. So we're going to squeeze this, and what you'll see is the gel come out. And I'm going to scrape that off, pop my lid on. Roll that off. Then you need a dampened dish with some gel residue wipe off solution. I have my little unicorn pot that is crying.
That looks like a cat.
It's not, it's a unicorn.
That looks like a cat with a horn stuck on it.
So with my gel brush, I am patting and pressing the Acrygel into the shape of the unicorn. Now you want to do this very thin. So this is why it's great to have that little bit of a guide. If the Acrygel starts to stick to your brush, clean your brush out in the gel residue wipe off solution, and then you can go again. So your brush needs to be damp with the gel residue wipe off solution. You can still see how we've drawn out the unicorn underneath. Makes everything a lot easier to do. And then the next step is to get the Urban Graffiti top coat, and we're going to go over the entire thing. This is going to get rid of the sticky layer. So we'll have no sticky layer, but we have gel to secure the stones down with. So we're going to use different stones today because I haven't used these in a video yet, I don't think. Have I, Adam?
I have no idea.
These are the AB stones that are, I think they're advertised as clear, so they have no backing on them. And they have a really nice Aurora Borealis colour, which I think is perfect for the unicorn. So we're going to pick those up and start to fill the shape. I'm going to press it into that gel. I'm going to go around the border first. And because they have a clear backing, you'll actually get a little bit of the colour that's underneath showing through. Then I'm going to come and do the neck. You can see as you press into that gel, it creates like a reservoir around the stone. And then I'm going to use these, and I absolutely adore them. They are tiny, tiny, tiny AB crystals. They have a pointy back, and I'm going to fill in this shape with these. Then I'm going to use the silver coated ones, and these have a coating of silver on them. And I'm using these for the mane. I've popped one in for the eye. They come in lots of different sizes. So you get a pack and there's lots of different sizes, which is great for when you're filling in nail art, because you can really use all those different sizes to create lots of different looks. Then I'm going to use a teardrop stone for the horn. Right, once you're happy with where those are placed, I'm going to pop those into the lamp. Look at it! Isn't she nice? I actually really like how it's turned out. I like all those little tiny pieces that are in, all those tiny, tiny, tiny stones. Then I've used, for the mane, I've put those silver ones on. I think that looks cool, and a silver eye. For the ear, I did use those tiny, tiny ones. There they are. Isn't she pretty? Should we give her a name?
Mm-hmm. John.
John.
Well, there are male unicorns, I'm assuming, or there wouldn't be any unicorns, because they have to...
Well, there must be male and female to reproduce.
So, John.
Doesn't look like a John. Looks like a Fiona. No, it doesn't look like a Fiona. It looks like a, I don't know, Sparkabella. So there you are, guys. guys, I hope you've enjoyed that unicorn-inspired nail. It's not too difficult if you break everything down. Have a play around with your stones and your acrygel. See what you can create. See you next time. Bye-bye.